In the last video, we looked at how you can convert text into numbers so that machine learning models can consume that text. In this video, we are going to look at two of those approaches, which is label encoding and one-hot encoding. Now, before we continue with the discussion, I would suggest that you follow some prerequisites, because in the coming videos, we will be doing some coding and you need to have basic knowledge on pandas. Now, I have pandas tutorial playlist. Go to YouTube, search code basics pandas. You find my tutorial playlist, very popular. And you need to follow first 6 or 7 videos just to get a basic understanding of pandas. After that, you need to know some machine learning fundamentals too. Again, I have a very popular playlist on YouTube, Core Basics Machine Learning playlist. In this, follow first maybe 8 or 10 videos, and then you can resume this series. We're going to talk about spam detection. So spam detection is a classical problem for text classification. Again, text classification falls under natural language processing domain. And this is a screenshot from my Gmail account. You all know Gmail very accurately detects the spam and saves us a lot of headache. So how do they do that? They use machine learning behind the scene. For example, this is again a real example of a spam email where they will use lucrative offers. They will say, I have $55 million in some bank account. And they will use this urgency, you know, urgent business assistance, that those kind of keywords. So how do they classify the text into spam and ham? Ham means not a spam. When you have a text, a typical approach is to convert that text into a vector. And this is also called text representation or feature engineering. Basically, machine learning models, they understand numbers. They don't understand text. That's the reason you need to convert text into numbers. And these numbers are often a vector. And this is called a vector space model. And you can then feed this to a machine learning model, such as naive Bayes classifier. Naive Bayes classifier is one type of machine learning model, and that can classify text into spam or no spam. Again, if you have followed that tutorial playlist, which I talked about, my machine learning tutorial playlist, you will have some understanding of what I'm talking about. So this is the overall approach. So by now you're clear that whenever you're solving NLP problem using machine learning, you have to convert text into number or a vector. Let's say I have these sample emails. The first and third email are regular email. The second email is spam. Let's discuss how we can convert text into numbers. So pause this video for a moment and just think about some approach. I think you will come up with some basic approach on your own. You don't need any guidance from any book or my video. Just think about it for a second. So one approach that we can come up with, very, very basic approach, is let's create a vocabulary out of all the words. So let's say I have 100 emails in my database, you know, and I'm using those 100 emails to train my machine learning model. I can take every word from those emails, maybe apply some stemming lemmatization, convert them into some base words, and build a vocabulary. Vocabulary is basically a collection of all the words in your emails. And the vocabulary may look like this. I have 3 dots, means let's say I have a few thousand words in my vocabulary. And how did I convert the, how did I generate these words? Well, I went over all the emails in my training data set and took each word. And each unique word is, you know, one word in the vocabulary. And let's say I assign numbers to these words. Let's say I sort them alphabetically and I assign these numbers. So number for add is 1, auto is 2, and so on. And then when you take any email, you're just doing a simple lookup. So let's say the number for hey is 12. You see, hey is 12. Pranav is 187. It's not visible, somewhere hidden in three dots. Ken is 7. You see, Ken is 7. And so on. You can create a simple vector or a list. You know, if you're using Python terminology, is vector is nothing but a list of numbers. You can create a simple vector to represent that text. And this is a very primitive way of representing text as a vector. It is called label encoding. You might have encountered this term label encoding if you have done machine learning. This is a very basic approach. All right, let's look at the second approach, okay? Second approach is, all these words are part of my vocabulary, okay? Add, auto, and three dot means, let's say I have 2000 words in my vocabulary. You put them like this, you know, at the top. And then you take your actual text that you want to convert into a vector. So let's say this is my email. Hey Pranav, can you add auto, whatever. And then for each word, what you will do is, you will create this kind of vector where the position of that word will have 1 and remaining words will have 0. For example, I have Ken here. So you see Ken here, so Ken is 1. Other words are 0. Similarly, hey and Pranav are kind of hidden in these three dots. I don't have enough space on my screen, so I can't show you the entire vocabulary, but you get the point. See here, add. So if you have a word add, the position for add is the first position. That will be 1. Remaining position is 0. And this is called one hot encoding. Again, if you have learned machine learning, you would know about one hot encoding because it's a popular technique used to represent categorical variables in machine learning. Okay, so again, not a rocket science, very, very simple concept that you have your entire vocabulary and wherever you assign an index in that list for each individual word, and wherever that word appears, you just put 1 at that position, remaining positions are 0. So we looked into two approaches, label encoding and one hot encoding. In NLP, people don't use these approaches. I just wanted to describe these approaches so that you at least know that these are primitive ways of representing text into a vector. There are certain disadvantages of these two approaches, and that's due to those disadvantages, they are not used much in machine learning nowadays. In machine learning nowadays, they use most of the time word embedding, TF-IDF, bag of words, okay? So let's look at the disadvantages of these two approaches. Let's say I have a sentence called I need help, and this is my one hot encoded vector. Let's say I train my model, and then for prediction, I get a sentence like I need assistance. Now, help and assistance are kind of similar word. So if I have a similar representation of these two words, it will help me. But here, see, this one hot encoding is kind of dumb because it just looks at the position of a word and puts 1 there. So if you look at these two vectors, help and assistance, they are very different. See, in help, I have all these zeros and 1 is at this position. Assistance, again, I have all these zeros and assistance, you know, here I have 1. Just by looking at these two vectors, you can't say that they are similar words. So one hot encoding doesn't capture the meaning of the word in an accurate way. So that's the disadvantage number 1. The second disadvantage is, let's say in my vocabulary, I have 100,000 words. In that case, you would have already sensed that each word will occupy the size of 100k. You know, the vector for each word would be 100k. That's too much memory. And that is just one word. What if I have an email that has 500 words in it? So now you multiply 500 with 100k, and that much memory I need just to represent one email into a vector. So it consumes not only too much memory, but when you are doing machine learning, it will waste a lot of compute resources. So that's the disadvantage number two. The third disadvantage is, let's say I have this vocabulary, I train my model, and when I got the actual email for prediction, okay, I completed my training, and when I'm getting an email for prediction, let's say it has this word called Bahubali, which is not part of my vocabulary. So how do you represent this into one hot encoding vector? Well, you can have undefined word as a last. You know, you can have the last word here in the vocabulary could be undefined or out of vocabulary. You can put it there, one there, but then every new word that you are encountering will have same numeric representation. So you see that this is not accurate, and it suffers from out of vocabulary problem. What if I had a numeric representation which can even represent the unknown words, you know, the words that it has not seen before in an accurate way? That would be cool. But clearly, label or one-hot encoding doesn't do this. And by the last memory problem that I talked about applies to one-hot encoding, not label encoding. But see, these two approaches are dumb, basically. Label encoding, one-hot encoding are dumb way of representing text into numbers. Let's move on to the next disadvantage. Let's say I have a sentence, I need banana. And I converted, I created one hot encoded vector for each of these words. And I want to feed this into machine learning model. I can flatten these three vectors and create a single list. Let's say each vector is 1,000 numbers each. I can flatten the list. Flatten means just join these three lists. I can create one list whose size is 3,000. Feed it into machine learning model. Okay, that's fine. But see, all my emails are not of the same size. So my next email could be, I need banana shake. In that case, the size of the flattened vector would be 4,000. And machine learning model expects similar size. They see, when you're defining machine learning model, let's say you are building a neural network. Your input layer of neuron has to be fixed size. It cannot change. You know, I can't feed 3,000 one time, 4,000 second time. It has to be same. So we need to come up with a numeric representation of a given sentence in such a way that for all the emails or for all the text, I get a fixed size vector. One hot encoding doesn't give me that. And that's the disadvantage number four. All right. So that's all I have for this session. I just wanted to quickly cover one hot encoding and label encoding. These are very primitive ways of doing text representation. And these approaches are not used in machine learning or NLP because of the four disadvantages that I mentioned in this video. In the next video, we are going to look into bag of words and we will do some coding. Don't worry. I know we have been having few videos where we did not do coding. So we are going to do some coding. Also, for last few videos, I have added exercises. So whenever you're watching my video in general, make sure you check out a video description because sometimes, you know, after publishing a video, I might add some exercises. So it's always beneficial that you check the video description. If you like this, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends. You can spread the word. I'm putting a lot of effort in making these videos. So if you find them useful, share it on LinkedIn. LinkedIn is a very good platform where people are serious about learning and about job, etc. So you can maybe add a post in LinkedIn and talk about your learning. All right, thank you.